guys, it's Shelly with Designs by Shelly Buchanan. Today I'm going to show y'all how to sublimate on a 12-ounce sippy cup from Amazon. They have a little plastic insert inside the lid, and this is the replacement straw and lid for when they outgrow the sippy cup top. The reason I go with these, they have this silicone inside of them, so when they're closed, you can flip them upside down and they're still proof. Same thing with the sippy cup lid. That's what this piece right here is. You can tell a difference. This one does not have it in there and this one does. Some people will actually start them out with this one with the silicone and then take it out to transition them. But I like these because when you tip them upside down, they do not spill everywhere on you. But I'm gonna start with this, and you're gonna see right here we have this groove. So when you hear me mention the groove, that's what that's about. The reason I start with my lid on is because typically a lot of people will do a design. Well, when you take the stuff off and you put the lid on, then it's kind of off. And I know it's probably not a big deal to most people, but to me, when you put the lid on, if the lid sits on it like this, I want my design to be showing the right way, not sideways like this when they're drinking out of it, because it's just personal preference. But so I'm gonna show y'all how I do this. Okay, so with the paper that I'm using, thankfully it makes it a whole lot easier because you can see through it. And I mean, if it's not a big deal to y'all, I completely understand. It's just my preference. So when I have that on in the direction that I want it, I'm gonna go ahead and take off the sippy cup lid just to be able to slide it up. I personally prefer the bottom to have less of an overlay than the top on most of them. And I've just got a heat mat laying in my lap, just anything to hold it flat. But I figured that way it's a little bit easier to prop my phone up in here than it is on the kitchen table. So now that I've got it laid right, I'm going to scoot my design down. You're gonna pick one side to hold near to you. It's not a big deal whichever side you pick. I personally typically pick the design how Grace ends right here, and I will pick that side, but it does not make a difference on which side you pick. So you're gonna pull your design tight, and then I'm gonna hold it up. You can see there's gonna be an overlay here, but there's not much of one on the bottom. And then I hold it up to the light to see if the way that the colors are, I try to get them as close to possible as running into each other. And then you're just gonna pull it very, very tight. And you're gonna tape. I try to start in the center or very close to the center. These sippy cups are a lot smaller than the other ones, so it's not a big deal. I'm gonna leave about a fingertip gap, and I'm gonna tape again. And you're just gonna repeat that. Once you get all the way to the bottom, I'm gonna start my way back up, and you'll notice on this way, I'm gonna hold my finger going this way and I'll tape on this side. That is to kind of keep it pulled tight, but also to help push out any extra air that's gonna be in there. So now once you have this taped, and it does not have to look pretty, I take my scissors, and you're gonna trim along the bottom. I've seen people use X-Acto knives. I've seen all kinds of stuff. It does not matter what you use, honestly. I just prefer to use scissors because when you hold them up against the cup, it's still gonna keep this very straight. I'm not saying it's gonna be 100% straight, but it is gonna keep it very straight. Once I do the bottom, then I go to the top, and you do not have to do it in that order. I know a lot of people think that if they do one step wrong, I mean, I have purposely tried different stuff just to see what would mess it up and what wouldn't, so I know if I mess something up, if it's gonna be a big deal or not. And so far, none of that stuff. I have taped this stuff, and then I have taped the top, taped the bottom, and then taped the seam. It has not made any difference for me. Some people say that the ghosting is caused by not getting the air out, which I do believe that. So I take my heat tape, and I'm gonna lay it on the seam. I'm gonna fold it inside of the cup, and then I'm gonna pull it tight, run my finger down, cut the tape, and then I'm gonna pull it tight and I'm gonna lay it. The reason I leave it this long, for a lot of stuff, you don't have to. With cups specifically though, I do, just because when it's in my convection oven, I can tell this is the way I start, then I go this way, then I can go this way. But that way, if something happens and the cup rolls a little bit when I'm trying to turn it or anything, I make sure that I don't get the same side twice. I've heard that that will actually cause your design to burn. So once I've done this, I'm gonna start with the top of the cup. You're just gonna do a layer of tape around the top. Move your tape up a little bit, and I'll explain why in just a second. And it does not have to be perfect. It does not have to be straight. Mine don't have lines and stuff in it. It's just the concept of it. So with doing the first layer, it went down here. The second layer left this overhang up here. Now you're just gonna fold that into your cup. The reason for this is if there's any air right in here, it will actually help push that out. I have tried it with just shrink wrap and just tape to hold the design in place. I personally did not care for it at all. It did not ghost in certain areas, I guess you would say, but it actually made the whole cup look like it just didn't transfer like it should. Everybody has a personal preference. I just prefer, unless it is, so like this, I want my colors to be vibrant. I mean, there's roses, there's sunflowers, stuff like that. And then I've had some that they like the lighter colored scheme. So for ones like that, I mean, I guess you wouldn't really notice a huge difference, but I just prefer mine like that. And then you're gonna take your tape, do the same exact thing to the bottom. And like I said, I do these typically when I'm not explaining at all. It takes me about 5 minutes to do one. And that is from printing the design. Once it's printed, that is cutting it. After the design is printed, that is cutting the design down to get the extra excess off to make it easier to work with, getting it prepped and in the oven and everything. And then I do 400 at 6 minutes and I turn every two. Once I get the bottom done, I'm just gonna hold it pretty tight and swirl it. And then because of the seam that was on this one, this is all you have to do for the 20 ounce, and then you put your shrink wrap on. Because there is that extra groove though, especially with her name gonna be right over that groove, I am going to go ahead and tape that to make sure we get all that extra air out. You do not have to do this. I did not do it on the other sippy cup that I'd done, but there was just a design there and there was not a name. But with it being a name and it being such narrow lines, I'm just gonna go ahead and do this just in case. And I do use a lot of tape. I have done, someone told me about doing painter's tape instead of shrink wrap. And so I did try it. I would advise if you're gonna be doing very many colors, go ahead and get shrink wrap and get a heat gun. Just because you use so much tape wrapping a full cup, this one, this size especially, but the bigger ones even more so. So I would suggest just going ahead and buying it. But if you're just starting out and trying to get a feel for it, I mean, it does work. I'm going to take my heat gun and I'm going to put it on a higher setting just so it does not take as long. And you just, I personally heat the top, kind of go around in a circle, and I'll kind of smush that extra down in there. Because they send you the same size no matter if you are ordering 12 or 20 ounce or 30 ounce. So you will have some extra on these, and that's just fine. So as you can tell, there is a lot of air pockets in there. Some people will not heat their shrink wrap. They will just go ahead and throw it in the convection oven. To me, if I'm going to use shrink wrap, I want it to be held tight when I put it in there, because I feel like then it would press the design over faster versus leaving it and waiting on it to tighten and then press the design, like to be held up against it. So I personally go ahead and heat mine. And then once I get it all done, you're going to see there's still some lines and stuff in it. It's not a big deal, because that is from where I did not do my tape perfect. That's where I just hurried up and done the tape. I will do the top, bottom, and the seam. And as y'all can tell, right here is the seam. You can see that through there on the video. So right here it has a hole. If it is a huge hole, I will just waste the shrink wrap, throw it out, and redo the shrink wrap. Just because the seam, the top, and the bottom seem to be the most typical spots to get ghosting. But, I mean, anywhere else on the cup, it's not a huge deal. Okay, I'm going to start my timer, and I'm going to go ahead and put this in the convection oven. So, while that is going, so I have done a whole variety of stuff. I've done mouse pads, shirts, keychains, I don't even know what all anymore. Magnets. You can do puzzles. I've not done a puzzle yet. I've actually got some coming in. I've got more bags coming in. You can sublimate on a lot of stuff. Depending on what you're doing, on what I would say you need to order for it. If you plan on doing tumblers, you are a lot better off to get heat tape and a heat gun and shrink wrap, in my opinion, just to save money in the long run, versus using a whole roll of tape to do a few tumblers. The heat tape, I use this from Amazon. I order a whole lot from Amazon. I typically pay about $2.50 for a roll of it. And I can do quite a few tumblers with it, because I'm not wrapping the entire tumbler. And the shrink wrap, I think I got like 100 of them for not much, $5, $6. So, just in my opinion, in the heat gun, you can get them ranging from $10 to $60 to $70, depending on what you need. Any of them will work. I got heat gloves because for as much as I'm going to be using them, it's worth it. If you're just starting out, you can do oven mitts, you can do pot holders, stuff like that. When I was first starting out, that's what I done, just to see if I was going to use it enough to make it worth it for me. But I gave in and got me some because I'm definitely going to use them enough to make it worth it. And when you're doing them in the convection oven, the biggest thing to remember is make sure you turn them. If you leave them laying, I've got to turn this one because my timer's going off. If you leave them laying flat on one side, I've not done it personally, but everybody says that it burns your design, because if the design is laying on a flat plate right here and it's constant being hot in this one area, all of this is getting heat, but this is getting extra heat. And that's why I recommend to turn them. The one that I'm using, I am going to get me a vertical one because I ordered one, didn't work out, whole mess. But a vertical one, you can just stand it up, and since your design is not going to be on the bottom, it's not a big deal if it just stands on it. But with it laying flat, you do have to rotate it. So I do a rotation every 2 minutes. And you can leave your design on when it comes out to cool. I've done it both ways, because as some people said, they were more vibrant if you leave them. Some people said it didn't make a difference. Some people said that if you didn't hurry and get the design off, the design would actually stick to it. I've done it both ways, and I personally cannot tell a difference. My colors are not more vibrant. They're not anything. So I personally just take them off whenever they get done so I can show y'all, or that way I can hurry up and send whoever I'm making it for, I can send them a video of it. Just because I don't really want to sit here an extra 15 minutes for it to cool, to have to take it off anyway. I mean, it just, I would just rather get it all done at once and be done. A lot of common questions though. Bulk ordering tumblers, you can do. There's a lot of groups on Facebook. Just watch who you order from, because some of them, if you actually look at their profiles and you look at their seller ratings and stuff, they're not actually certified sellers. I personally pay a little bit more to get mine from Amazon, just because I know I'm going to get my product. Whereas there's been a lot of people who've ordered from these groups on Facebook. They are not certified sellers. They'll have a profile who will comment saying, hey, you know, I order from this person all the time. They're great. You should order from them. And then they come to find out that that's actually another account that they've created. I posted actually, and I asked for recommendations on buying in bulk on these specific tumblers. And I mean, I was very specific on what I was looking for. And so I had all these people comment saying, oh, I use this person. Oh, I use this person. And the same exact profile picture, everything is on one, saying, you know, these are examples of some of the cups that I have made with these blanks that I'm selling. But then two or three comments later, somebody else comments with the exact same picture. And if you look on the picture, they've actually got a mark, like a watermark on these pictures. They're not even their picture. Their page has this name, but then the logo on it is not their page. So to me, that's automatically a red flag, because if I personally do one, most of the time I don't even post a watermark. If someone specifically says, you can post my cup on your group, but do not post to where someone else can screenshot it, or someone else can say, you know, take a picture and say, oh, I had this made for them. I've actually got that quite a few times. So I personally will tag who it was that had the cup made. But I do not personally do a watermark, and if I do, it's gonna be my watermark. It is not gonna be some random person's watermark. So just be very careful when you're buying off of social media platforms, because a lot of times people do not actually get their products. Some of them are verified sellers, but a lot of them are just scam people who found an easy way to do that. So I would just be very careful of that. Heat tape and heat gloves, heat mats. I ordered heat mats, and I was back and forth between Walmart and Amazon for these. I don't remember which one I ended up going with, but they're all the same. I mean, the size is a big difference, but overall, they're all the same. It's not a huge difference. The price does vary a lot from one seller to the next, but I personally would rather not lose my money, so I go with a verified seller over just some random person who's posted on Facebook or somewhere like that. So now that this one's done, and they are going to be very hot when they come out. That's typically what the heat glove is for. And you just kind of pull up on the little flap that we folded down on the inside of the cup. If you just kind of pull up on that, it's going to make a huge difference. But then it will actually pull up. This one's gonna be a little bit more difficult because I did wrap around so much tape at the name part of it. And typical videos would not have been this long. Reason being is typically this takes me about 5 minutes. I would have videoed, showed y'all, and done. But I prefer to show y'all the finished product just so y'all don't run into the problem of trying this and it not working out for y'all. This way y'all can see that this technique actually does work. and that way you're not wasting a bunch of tumblers, sippy cups, whatever it is that you happen to be working on. And I definitely recommend keeping a trash can right here next to you and scissors, because I use them a lot. So then once you get that done, if you just peel, and some of this is already peeled off, that's fine though. Whenever I was peeling that other tape off. And it's gonna be hot for a good few minutes, so your hands will get nice and warm. You just peel up all this tape. And then you lift it. Still kind of warm. I'm gonna turn to where the light's gonna hit it better. So right here is my seam. You can tell I almost had them lined up perfect. I mean, it's not noticeable from back here, so it's not a huge deal. And then I need to turn it that way, I think. And then I do have a cup turner that I will typically put them on to send videos to whoever it was that made them, or to whoever it was that asked me to make them. I just typically don't put them on there for these videos because the way my lighting is over there, you can't really see it too good. And since I'm in my bedroom instead of the dining room, it just does not work out good as far as videoing it either. But once that is done, then your sippy cup is all done. And they say to let them cool before you put the lid back on, but I'm gonna do it anyway just to show y'all. So now it's perfectly lined up. Here's the center of the design. Here's the center of this. That is why I personally leave my sippy cup lids on, just to mark where the design needs to go, and then you can take it off, of course. But if y'all have any questions or anything about any stuff that y'all want to see videos on, just leave me a comment, and hopefully this video helps y'all out. Thank y'all for watching.